In order to find the moment of forces about point A, we can start by establishing our sign convention. In this case, I'm considering counterclockwise moment as positive. Next, let's look at our force F1 having a magnitude of 375 acting vertically downward. Now, the moment arm this force make with point A is 8 feet. Multiplying the force with its moment arm will give us the magnitude of the moment. Next, we also still have to establish either it is making a clockwise or counterclockwise moment. Since the force is acting downward and the moment arm is to the left of the force, it is going to make our clockwise moment. Next, let us look at force F2 that is acting at an angle. So we can go ahead and first resolve it into its vertical and horizontal component. We can do that by utilizing the information in the right angle triangle. So in this case, the hypotenuse of a right angle triangle is given to us as 5, whereas the opposite is 4. So multiplying 500 with 4 over 5 will project it along the vertical axis. This is basically the sine theta that we are multiplying 500 with. Similarly, we can project it along the horizontal axis by multiplying 500 with 3 over 5. Once we have the components, let's go ahead and figure out what moment they make. So starting with the horizontal component, since the force vector is in the line of action of point A, it is not going to create any moment or any turning effect. This force vector is basically pushing point A. Next, the vertical component will make our moment having a moment arm of 14 feet. Again, this is making our clockwise rotation. Finally, let's resolve our force F3. We are given an angle of 30 degrees from the vertical, so we can project it along the vertical direction by taking the cos 30 function. Whereas, in order to get the horizontal component, we are multiplying the force with sine 30. That will give us the horizontal component. Once we have the component, let's figure out the moment. So the moment created by the vertical component will still be in the clockwise direction, having a moment arm of 19 feet. However, the horizontal component of force F3 is going to make our counterclockwise moment. In this case, the moment arm is 0.5 feet. Now, once we have all the moments figured out, let's add them all together. Simplifying, we get the value of negative 11,192.7 pound feet. Since we have considered the counterclockwise moment as positive, the negative sign is indicating that the resultant moment acting at point A is in clockwise direction.